Hello, my name is Russell Den and I'm an educator at the WSET School in London, and I'm here to take you through some training options within the vineyard. So we've got five things that we want to look at, but first we need to think about, well, why does the vineyard need to be managed? So there are lots of reasons why the vineyard needs to be managed. It allows the vineyard to be worked more easily. We've got vines organised within a specific space. It allows uniform ripening of fruit, which is really important for the grape grower, so that each vine receives a similar level of sunlight and warmth. And it also creates a more open canopy so that we can prevent attack from certain pests and diseases. In order to manage the vineyard, there are a few things that the vineyard manager, some techniques they can use to arrange the vine in a certain way. So the first thing that they can do is pruning. So pruning is the removal of unwanted structures on the vine. So that might be leaves or shoots or permanent wood. The main pruning activity is done in winter. So the vine is dormant, and this is the point at which the vineyard manager will decide essentially how big they want the vine to grow. So that might mean leaving somewhere between 8 and 20 buds on the vine. So they're essentially making a decision in terms of how much growth they want from the vine in the next growing season, and ultimately how much fruit they want from each vine. The second pruning option is in summer. So a summer prune is an opportunity for the vineyard manager to fine-tune the shape and size of the vine. So this might involve removing leaves, exposing bunches to sunshine. It might mean trimming shoots, controlling the height of the green growth. So that's pruning, typically in winter, and some fine-tuning in summer. So the second technique is training. So training is molding the vine into a specific shape. So what we need to bear in mind is that the vine is a climbing plant. Given the opportunity, it will grow across the ground, it will grow up structures that it comes into contact with. So training allows us to create a certain shape of vine within the vineyard. Our final technique available to the vineyard manager is the use of a trellising system. Now, this isn't always necessary. I would say most of the time we would see a network of wires, training posts within the vineyard, and this just provides some structures to arrange the vine in space. It's a climbing plant. We've got that network of wires and posts to allow the vines to grow up and organise the direction, the shape in which the vine grows. So they're the techniques available to the vineyard manager. In terms of our training options, we're going to look at three pruning options, and then we'll look at two other considerations. So the first form of pruning that we're going to look at is replacement cane pruning. So this is a pruning system whereby we have a small amount of permanent wood, typically quite a short trunk. We have a cane, which is a one-year-old shoot, and that cane is supporting the shoots that have grown over the previous growing season. At the end of the growing season, as we move into winter, the vineyard manager is going to make two cuts. The first cut removes the existing cane. The second cut will create a spur, so that's a short cane with two or three buds on it, as close to the center of the trunk as possible. So we're left with a spur and a single shoot, which will then be bent down to form the cane in the next growing season. We can establish a vineyard a little bit more quickly, but in terms of deciding which is going to be our spur, which is going to be the cane in the next year, it's a little bit more complicated. So the second technique that we're going to look at is spur or cordon pruning. This involves leaving a greater quantity of permanent wood on the vine. So we have our trunk, we have an arm or a cordon which supports the growth within a particular growing season. To prune in this fashion, The vineyard manager will make several cuts to remove a shoot at each growing point in its entirety, but leave a spur, that's our cane, with two or three buds at each growing point. And then come the next growing season, those buds will support the growth in the following year. So the final pruning system that we're going to look at is head trained, spur pruned. So this is more unusual in that we have a slightly larger quantity of permanent wood and the head is arranged into a few sections. And each of those sections, each of those parts of the head will support some spurs to give us our growth within the growing season. The bush vine is pruned in a similar way to a spur or cordon pruned system. So we would remove the shoots to leave one or more spurs at each part of the head. It's perhaps slightly more unusual in that it doesn't require a trellis. It's self-supporting. And this is a training system that might be used in perhaps warmer climates where we've got some natural protection, some natural shading of the green structures on the vine to create a slightly cooler canopy. Okay, so the fourth thing that we're going to look at as part of this session is vine density. So this is an expression of how many vines the vineyard contains. So that's usually expressed as the number of vines per hectare, so 100 meters square. And there are lots of factors that can influence how many vines we're going to have in a certain space. The two most important factors are the amount of water that's available to the vine and the amount of nutrients that are available to the vine. So with these two most important considerations, we can think about three different scenarios. So the first scenario might be where we've got lots of water and we've got lots of nutrients. So in this situation, the vine's got all the ingredients that it needs. We would typically opt for low density planting, but the vines would typically be larger. So we can control the amount of water and nutrient available to the vine by having a bigger vine system. The second scenario might be one where we've got very little nutrients and very little water available to the vine. In this situation, it's more typical to go for low density planting, but have much smaller vines. And that way each vine's got the access to the maximum amount of space in order to make sure that it's got enough water and enough nutrients to produce the amount and quality of the fruit that the vineyard manager needs. Those vines are typically small and they're close to the ground. So finally, we've got a scenario where we might have lots of water availability, but lower levels of nutrients. And in this situation, we would typically go for high density planting. So that might be anywhere between 8 and 10,000 vines per hectare. The idea here is that we have smaller vines and we plant those vines closer together to establish a sense of competition. So each of the vines is competing for water with the other vines around it. And hence we can control the growth of the vine in that way. The final thing that we're going to look at here is the concept of yield and quality. So yield is the amount of fruit that we get from a given area. There's lots of different ways in which we can express yield, but the most common way is to express it as hectolitres per hectare. So the amount of liquid we get from a given area. Generally speaking, lower yields mean better quality of fruit. So if we've got a smaller amount of fruit being produced from a vineyard, those vines are receiving a greater proportion of sunlight, warmth, nutrients. They are putting that energy into producing a smaller quantity but of better quality fruit. So that is more often the case. Typically speaking, when the yield goes up, so the amount of fruit that we get from a given area is higher, then the level of dilution, so the amount of fruit, the amount of energy that the vine puts into the grapes is spread out across a larger number of bunches. So we tend to get more fruit, but that fruit isn't quite as concentrated in terms of the sugars, the flavors and aromas, colors, tannins, etc. So the quality is typically yes. So in most instances, high yield often means perhaps a little bit more dilute fruit, although we're getting a greater quantity of fruit. However, I think it's important to note that providing we can effectively manage the vine, its access to water, nutrients, sunlight, and heat, then it's still possible to produce large quantities of really good quality fruit. Okay, so let's take a look at a theory question relating to the training of the vine. So our question is, identify and describe two types of pruning methods. And this is a 6-mark question. Our command verbs here are identify and describe. So to identify, we need to say what they are. And to describe, we need to give a little bit more information about each of those techniques. So the answer here is, well, we've got replacement cane pruning, which is where we have a shorter, smaller trunk and a cane which supports the growth within the growing season. And then the alternative pruning method would be spur pruning. So this is where we have typically a larger amount of permanent wood, the trunk, and an arm or a cordon that supports the growth in a given year. Okay, so that concludes our session on training the vine. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.